opened for business in 1962. We are just about ready for baseball from Dodger Stadium in Los Angeles. Should be a good one here this afternoon between the Houston Astros and the Tampa Bay Rays. Rays baseball comes your way next. Now at the plate, here is Jose Altuve. He will lead this one off today. Here comes the 1-2. And just a Chamber of Commerce afternoon for baseball. 82 degrees here at first pitch. The 2-2. Hit on the ground to third. Reined in. And the day begins with an out. There's one away. Next, it'll be Alex Bregman. One out, nobody on. A ball and two strikes now.
Well, somebody's sitting off speed right here. Only way he was late on that heater is he was expecting another changeup.
Swing and a miss on the fastball that time. Out number two. And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Here comes the 1-2. A swing and a high drive to right center field. Kiermaier looks up. And goodbye. This one ain't coming back. Into the box now, Carlos Correa got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Now to the plate, here is Austin Meadows. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Ah, gets him to swing at a pitch down and out of the zone, 1-2.
Really deceptive changeup right there. It died right before the plate, and he was left reaching for air.
Now a fastball up around the shoulders, but it's strike three called and a questionable first out of the inning. All even now, 2-2. Bases are empty, one man out. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out. Here's Randy Arozarena. Two outs already on the K this inning, so he'll be looking to do better. That nibbled the corner there, but missed. 2-1.
Gonna be a long day if he executes like this, punching tickets right out of the gate.
Fouled away. Here now the 2-2. Fouled off wide at first, but boy, that had some zip on it. And just a masterful job of pitching here as he strikes out the side in order. That'll bring up Yordan Alvarez, as it'll be 5, 6, and 7 due up to kick off the second inning. Set. Here comes the 1-1. And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two. Well hit, but right into the teeth of the shift. But that finds its way through for a base hit. Standing in now, Yuli Gurriel. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. Ready to deliver the 1-2.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Into the corner and slicing foul. Alvarez on at first, nobody out. Heading out towards shallow right. Margot will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first. One out, runner at first, and in to hit next will be the outfielder Kyle Tucker. Two one, here it is. High and deep to right center. Racing back, the right fielder at the track, and that one is gone. So now to the plate, Miles Straw. Fly ball right down the line and left. Left fielder is on the move, and he makes the catch in the corner.
Not enough.
So now to the plate, Jason Castro. And he's a little too high with that one. Two balls and a strike. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
It's clear he just hasn't been able to find any rhythm out there. Pretty much unable to hit any of his spots, and now he's at 3-1, and he's put him into another great hitting count.
Margot's on the move. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Last half of the second set to go, and next to bat will be the first baseman, G-Man Choi.
Hey, Matty, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
2-2 the count. Swing and a liner. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is aboard.
Matty, good. The right fielder.
To the plate now, Manuel Margot. Now a ball hit pretty well to left, but this is going to wind up in the seats foul. 3-2 pitch. A ground ball to third, and they could get two. Altuve for one. To Gurriel, and they get them both. Ready now is Joey Wendell to try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. Swing and a liner. Into the slide, and he comes up with a great catch to end the inning. Second baseman Jose Altuve. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Now the 1-1 pitch is laid off for ball two. Lined hard toward right center, and that's a base hit. 1-for-2 in his first couple of plate appearances. In now, Alex Bregman. Off the outside that time as the breaking ball can't catch the zone.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
And he fouls this one off. And it's fouled away.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Full count, 3-2. And the payoff pitch. Donnie finally wears him down here as he strikes him out after a 9-pitch at-bat. Next, here is Michael Brantley, and we'll see what he can do here after going deep his first time up.
Goes to show you how strong this guy is. That wasn't a bad breaking ball that he hit for a home run in the last at bat. That ball was down and away. He went out and hooked it and pulled it. This guy's definitely a good hitter.
There goes Altuve. On a line to shortstop. And now a throw to first, and they got him. Never really had a chance with the hit and run on as he gets doubled up on the line drive. Leading off the inning, it'll be Willy Adames as they'll look to spark the offense and even things up. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball.
The offense better get it going right here because they certainly can tell from their dugout. This guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Another 1-2 delivery. Now a rocket deep down the line in left. And that one skips up over the wall for a ground rule double. Into the box, Kevin Kiermaier. In tight with the slider, 2-2. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Chasing after it is Tucker. He makes the catch, and the runner from second will tag and head for third. And he'll make it up to third safely here with one away. Now a man at third with one away, and that'll bring up the catcher, Mike Zunino. Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1. Wanted to go after the slider, but he holds off, 3-1.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
3-2, full count. Adames takes his lead at third with one away. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order. So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Austin Meadows, 0-for-1, went down looking his first time up. Oh, and he's going to get rung up on a curveball, and that looked like a questionable strike at best. Two away. Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. Hit out towards second. And that'll get on through into right field for a base hit. Soar, the runner from third. Into the box now, Randy Arozarena fouled off. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Got him swinging, made him chase outside the zone that time, and that puts an end to the inning. New inning set to get underway, and ambling over to the batter's box is Carlos Correa. Changeup gets him out in front for strike two. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes. Now the Astros designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez. The 2-1 pitch. Here's a big swing and a miss on the fastball, 2-2.
With the way this guy's throwing on the mound, you cannot be chasing. You have to set your sights a little bit lower and control the strike zone.
And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2. Fouled away. Good battle. Count remains full. One out, nobody on. Another one sent foul. Hit high and deep out there to left center field. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. So the bases are empty here with two gone. And digging in to bat next, the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. And And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. Strike taken up in the zone. The 2-2. And he fouls this one off. Liner in there for a base hit. Standing in now, Kyle Tucker, sent on the ground out to second. He'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. G-Man Choi the next to hit. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full. 3-2.
This guy's been throwing the ball great so far, but he's going to be tested here. 4, 5, and 6 coming up this part of the lineup.
Lifted the other way down the left field line. Under it now is Brantley, and he has it for the first out. So here is Manuel Margot. One run on 3 hits. No errors for Tampa Bay so far. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Greinke steps into his windup. Here comes the pitch. High chopper to third. Throw on to first is in time, and Greinke's got himself 2 outs. Now into the box, Joey Wendell, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. The 1-1 home.
No, that's close.
Hey. 2-2 now.
He must know something we don't know. That was a center cut heater with count leverage in a big spot. I don't understand why he's taken.
This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. And indeed it will. He throws him out at first, and the side is retired. Late now is Miles Straw, comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. Now the 1-1 pitch. Hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd, foul. This is popped up. Throw won't be in time as he reaches it first.
Up next to the Astros, the catcher.
At the plate, Jason Castro. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike.
He's not having his best outing in this one, and I think that curveball is part of the reason why. He couldn't get on top of that one, and that's not the first time that's happened.
Adames has it, and there's one gone. So up to the plate next will be Jose Altuve. He's 1-for-2 in the ballgame. One home.
Wow, I'm shocked the hitter took it right there. That's a well-executed pitch down in the zone to try and get that double play.
He's good.
And a dive, but he's back in there. Strong stands at first with 1 out. 1-2 pitch is a bit high, and he's back to even at 2-2.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there. 2 away. One. And it's fouled away. 3-1 our score as we play inning number 5. High in the air down the right field line. And it's a foul ball.
Nope. Easy take there as the off-speed pitch misses well inside.
Two and two.
You can really tell about how effective this guy's going to be when guys are swinging at that changeup. So far in this one, they've been real smart to let it go.
Fouled off.
You know, taking you inside the mind of a batter right here, you can't get in auto swing mode. You still have to control the strike zone.
He did well to get a piece that time, and it'll stay 2-2.
I know the fans love the souvenirs, but the battle between the pitcher and
that will have to press pause as that strike three to retire the side. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and coming forward now is the shortstop, Willy Adames. The 1-1. Hit in the air to center field. Straw is right there, one down. Now one down with the bases empty, and that means Kevin Kiermaier will hit next.
Kiermaier.
The 1-1.
Ball two.
Changeup called a strike, and he comes back even at 2-2. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Now got it. Catcher.
Here now is Mike Zunino. Worked a walk in his first plate appearance.
Ball.
Lays off the slider that time. 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
High in the air into shallow left center. Center fielder giving chase. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. Ryan Sheriff takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Number 71.
Stepping in once again is Michael Brantley. He'll be the one leading things off for Houston in the sixth. 1-1 home. Now a swing, and the bat breaks in two that time. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out. So here's the Astros cleanup hitter, Carlos Correa. 0-for-2 on his line thus far. The 2-1 home.
That's ball three.
Yordan Alvarez will be next. Bonnie bailed him out with a swing. 3-2 now.
Hey, there was great arm action on that 3-1 changeup right here. He's got this guy thinking. That's the beauty right now. We go to a full count. Do you sit changeup?
He's out.
Or do you stay with the heater?
Throw in time at first for out number two. Now the 3-2 pitch. And that one's taken outside for a ball. We walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a two-out base runner. A 1-1. Rolled slowly down the first baseline. But a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Takes this the other way to right. In there, a base hit. You hold it second, and there are two aboard now. Stepping in now, Kyle Tucker. And a sinker there, swung on and missed for out number three. To the plate now is the designated hitter, Austin Meadows. He'll lead it off against Zach Greinke to open up the inning. 1-1 home. Swing and a liner. And he will whip this one over to first in time for the out. And now in the box, Brandon Lau. He singled in two trips to the plate thus far. Fouled away. We're in the sixth inning here in a 3-1 ball game. In the air down the line in left. And that'll get down for a base hit. And he'll reach second now with one away.
Up next to Tampa Bay, the left fielder.
To plate now, Randy Arozarena. Swing and a ball hit out toward right center. On the run is Tucker. He makes the running play. Two down. Next to hit is G-Man Choi. One for two on his line so far in the game. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Slider that runs inside that time, and that'll keep him from diving out over the plate. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Colin McHugh is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 31.
So stepping in is Miles Straw. He's one for two in the ball game. Now the 1-1 pitch. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide at first. The 1-2.
At the ball.
This is on the ground over to first. He's got it, and he'll step on first for the out. Three unassisted.
Now back.
Jason Castro, the catcher, is in. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. And he misses 2-1. Too high that time, and it's 3-1.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
And he takes ball four, so a good job out of the nine hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order. And he misses again, ball four, and that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball. So it's a tight spot here. First and second, one man out, and that'll bring up the LSU product, Alex Bregman. We're in the seventh inning with a good finish brewing, 3-1 our score. In the dirt here. Good job to corral this quickly as the runners hold on. The 2-2. Strikeout here yet again. It's been a ball game to forget thus far. Four strikeouts. Big spot here. First and second. Two men gone. And Michael Brantley settles in to hit at the plate. And he fouls this one off. He's set. And the 1-2 pitch. Castro over at second. Altuve on at first with two down. To two balls and two strikes now.
Number three hole hitter up right now. Cleanup guy on deck. Two ball, two strike count. I think pitcher wants to make something happen right here.
Hit on the ground out to short. Adamas brings it in. On the first, and the Astros can't cash in as that ends the inning. Digging in will be Manuel Margot, grounded out in his last at bat. 1-1 home. And it's fouled. The 1-2. Still a ball and two strikes. hit in the air down the right field line. Tucker waits on it. One away. Joey Wendell digs in now. He bounced out last time up. One earned on the docket for Greinke thus far into his seventh inning of work. And the count will be full. 3-2 pitch. Pulled toward right center field. Center fielder on the run. He gets there and makes a fine running play for the second out. So the next to bat will be Willie Adames. He flew out in his last debut. And this is low, ball two. Two and one.
Well, he's thrown a lot of pitches in this one, but it's not like he's walking a bunch of guys. Only one free pass to this point, but.
And we'll just leave it there as they make the play to end the inning. Chaz Rowe has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 50.
Set for the start of the inning, and stepping up as the shortstop, Carlos Correa. The 1-2 is offered at and missed. He chased it for strike three. Next will be the designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez. It was a walk in his last trip. Now the 1-1 pitch. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike
one ball, two.
Two
strikes.
Lifted down the line and left. And foul. Here he comes again. 1-2.
Back-to-back sliders in on the hands. He didn't handle it real well at all in the previous pitch, so why not come right back with it again? Better job of laying off that one, though.
Fastball just inside. And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
In time to first, and there are two away. Dig in. Yuli Gurriel. His career numbers against this pitcher. Just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. Here it comes on 1-1. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball two. Now a swing and a fly ball. And this will wind up a foul ball. Two-two, here it is. Full count now. 3-2. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. The 3-2 one more time. Hit in the air out to center field. Kiermaier's got a read on it. And that will end the inning. Pedro Baez is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 52.
So here's Kevin Kiermaier. No hits to this point. The 3-1 is in there for a full count now. 3-2.
This offense has been underachieving all day, putting way too much pressure on their own pitching staff. Someone has to have a quality AB and get this line going.
Popped him up. Bregman has room in territory. Makes the play, one away. So next to hit is Mike Zunino. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. One home. Fouled off. Hit in the air down the right. And it's a foul ball. Eighth inning of this low scoring affair. 3-1 our score. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at bat will continue. The next 1-2 pitch. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first, and no swing. It's ball two. Don't quite know where that one missed, but it's not for me to decide. 3-2.
You could get that fastball coming. A challenge fastball right here. He cannot allow the nine-hole hitter to get on base with the top of the order looming.
Bases are empty. One man out. Fouled away. Pitch on its way now to Zunino. Swung on and hit in the air to left. Brantley's after it. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning. The plate now for the Rays is the DH. Austin Meadows. Career numbers against Baez. Not a big sample size. 0-1. That's a foul ball off to the left, and it moves to 1-2. Now the pitch. And it's to 2-2 now with the bases empty and two gone here in the inning. He struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game. Ryan Thompson enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Set to start the ninth in this one. Digging in is the outfielder, Kyle Tucker. Now the 2-1. Lifted the other way down the left field line. Long run for the left fielder, but he won't get to it, and this should put a man in scoring position to start the inning. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
Now batting number 3.
Into the box, Miles Straw. Slider can't find his own here, and he's behind now 3-1. Sent on the ground out to second. And that's through into right field for a base hit. He'll come home with it. And this will not be close, and the run will score easily.
Up next to the Astros, the catcher, Jason Castro.
In now, Jason Castro. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left.
And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
Step out of the box and wash that one off, because that was an ugly swing.
Down the left field line and deep. And he dives, but he can't make the play. It lands foul. The 1-2. And this is swung on and missed. And boy, they took care of a key man there. One away. So it's a tight spot here. First and second, one man out, and that'll bring up Alex Bregman. 1-1.
Two balls.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
Ready with two balls and a strike.
Ball.
Slider misses, and he's in danger of losing him here. 3-1.
3-1 here. You have to make a good pitch on the mound. Grooving one here rarely works in your favor unless the hitter tries to do too much with it.
And that'll get down out there near the wall. Nick Anderson enters the game with one gone in the top of inning number 9.
Michael Granton.
Into the box now, Michael Brantley. There's a swing and a missile sent out to center field. That goes Kiermaier. On the warning track, he makes the catch. And he will come across to score on the sacrifice fly, as this is now a 6-1 ball game. Digging in next, Carlos Correa, runner in scoring position with two gone. Set, and the 2-1 pitch. This one's down to third. Throw on to first, and they're able to escape the monster inning as the side is retired. Blake Taylor, a southpaw standing 6'3", gets the ball now out of the bullpen. Now to bat, Brandon Lau. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. Set. Here comes the 1-1. And it's 1-2.
1-2.
Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away. And now here is Randy Arozarena. Flew out last time up.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Strong is there, and quickly two are gone here, and it's not looking good for the home nine. Next to bat will be the Tampa Bay cleanup hitter, G-Man Choi. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. Two balls and a strike to the Rays' first baseman. Should the lead hold up in this one, the win would belong to Zach Greinke. Here is a ground ball now for the shortstop to the right of second. On to first, and that will seal matters here this afternoon.
You might think it's just another win, but it's awfully hard to win in this game, especially on the road. But they find a way to get it done, and they should be very happy with this performance.
6-1, the final tally today. Houston jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Zach Greinke is the winning pitcher of record. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
Fans are final line.